subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 10th of December. India pays tributes to defense chief killed in chopper crash, cremation held with full military honors. Pakistani Taliban end ceasefire, future of peace talks uncertain. And Sri Lanka rolls out COVID booster shots to all over 30 amid Omicron scare. And now for all the details. India on Friday paid last respect to its first Chief of Defence Staff, General Bipin Rawat, who was killed along with his wife and 11 other personnel in a chopper crash on Wednesday. As per protocol, General Rawat was accorded a 17-gun salute at his funeral. Several dignitaries, including India's top political and military leadership, paid tributes to the defense chief. Military commanders of Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Nepal and Bangladesh also attended the last rites.
India on Friday paid last respects to its first Chief of Defense Staff or CDS General Bipin Rawat, who was killed along with his wife and 11 other personnel in a chopper crash on Wednesday. CDS Rawat, who led one of the world's largest armed forces, and his entourage had been flying to a hillside military college on Wednesday when the helicopter came down in heavy fog. Only one person survived the crash, and the Indian Air Force has commissioned an inquiry into the incident. Hundreds of soldiers escorted the carriage bearing the 63-year-old general's body on its final journey through India's capital. Onlookers showered flowers on Rawat's coffin during the funeral procession, and dozens holding the Indian flag ran alongside the carriage, some shouting "Hail Mother India." He was later cremated with full military honours, including a 17-gun salute, and his daughter performing the last rites. Several dignitaries, including India's top political and military leadership, paid tributes to the defence chief. Military commanders of Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Nepal and Bangladesh also attended the last rites.
We are all heartbroken. In fact, many in our military, senior personnel in our military at the level of General Admiral, had actually, in fact, known him well. He is a friend of Sri Lanka.
PM Modi had handpicked Rawat, a decorated general, as CDS in late 2019. With a mission to reorganize India's Army, Air Force and Navy into a single modern force with US-style joint theater commands. His death comes at a critical time for India, which is embroiled in a months-long standoff with China along parts of their shared border.
In news from Pakistan, the Pakistani Taliban or Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan declared an end to a month-long ceasefire on Thursday, arranged with the aid of the Afghan Taliban. The militant group accused the Pakistan government of breaching terms, including a prisoner release agreement and the formation of negotiating committees.
The Pakistani Taliban or Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan or TTP declared an end to a month-long ceasefire, accusing Prime Minister Imran Khan's government of breaching terms by not releasing more than 100 prisoners as promised and not appointing negotiating teams to conduct talks. The agreement was arranged by the Afghan Taliban leaders in November, and the two sides had been meeting across the border in Afghanistan. It also said security forces had carried out raids while the ceasefire was in force. The TTP is a separate movement from the Afghan Taliban and has fought for years to overthrow the government in Islamabad. Last month's ceasefire was always said to run until Thursday, with a possibility of extending if both parties agreed, was the latest in a series of attempts to broker a settlement to end conflict. Best known in the West for attempting to kill Malala Yousafzai, the schoolgirl who went on to win Nobel Prize for her work promoting girls' education, TTP has killed thousands of military personnel over the years and also claimed 2014 Army Public School attack that killed more than 130 children.
More on news from Pakistan. Members of Baloch community on Thursday held a massive protest in Pakistan's capital Islamabad to highlight the rampant enforced disappearances by Pakistani forces in Balochistan. The protest came as a senior Baloch leader, Yusuf Masti Khan, was also arrested on Thursday on the charge of making a provocative and anti-state speech in Balochistan's Gwadar.
Scores of members of the Baloch community protested on Thursday against the rampant enforced disappearances by the Pakistani security forces in Balochistan. Organized by the Baloch Republican Party, the protesters shouted slogans and demanded to give justice to the Baloch people. They demanded the immediate withdrawal of what they termed as occupying forces from the region while urging the international community to intervene. Holding placards and banners, they called for the release of all forcefully disappeared Baloch people. The protest came as a senior Baloch politician and Baloch Mutahida Mahaj president, Yusuf Masti Khan, was arrested on Thursday on the charge of allegedly making a provocative and anti-state speech at the protest sit-in staged by the people of Gwadar in Balochistan. The Human Rights Commission of Pakistan has also condemned the arrest. Activists blame there has been a sharp rise in human rights violations in Balochistan since the launch of the multi-billion China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or CPEC, which has only brought debt and destruction for the local people instead of economic opportunities.
43-year-old Hadia, a former Afghan school teacher, like many other women, lost her job when the Taliban seized Kabul and is now forced to work as a shoe shiner to make ends meet for her family. The abrupt withdrawal of foreign aid following the Taliban victory has sent Afghanistan's fragile economy into freefall, leaving millions facing hunger and making once well-off middle-class families destitute.
Under the previous Afghan government, 43-year-old Hadia, like many other women, had a job and was working as a school teacher, a career that spanned a decade. But things changed quickly when the Taliban seized Kabul in August, and one by one, she, along with other members of her family, lost their jobs and her son had to quit studies. Now Hadia sits by a roadside in Kabul on a neatly folded rug, trying to scrape a living by being a shoe shiner. Since sweeping to power, Taliban officials have said women would be able to work and study within the limits laid down by Islamic law. But there has been widespread uncertainty about what practical effect that will have on their ability to keep their jobs. Meanwhile, as Afghanistan struggles with an economy and banking system on the brink of collapse and a severe drought, the United Nations has projected that poverty may become nearly universal by mid-2022, affecting more than 90% of the country's 39 million people.
اگر امارات اسلامی و سایر جهان توجه نکنه برای مردم افغانستان فاجعه بشری بسیار بزرگی را افغانستان شاهدش می باشد.
Earlier this month, in what it described as an alarming socio-economic outlook for Afghanistan for the next 13 months, the UN pushed $100 million cash for work project to boost employment and $90 million in small business payments. Yet, for now, in the face of growing poverty, people like Hadia could only urge the Taliban to allow women to work in order to make ends meet.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. In a bid to curb the spread of the coronavirus amid the festive season and the emerging threat from the Omicron variant, Sri Lanka on Friday rolled out the Pfizer-BioNTech booster shot for people over 30 years of age. Those who have received two doses of any COVID-19 vaccine within 3 months are eligible for the booster shot. Various centres have been put up across Sri Lanka for the inoculation drive. The island nation, as on Friday, reported 11,917 active cases of coronavirus. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa's office said COVID vaccination cards are being made mandatory for people to visit public places. The president, in a meeting with Special Committee on COVID-19 Control, directed that the process of administrating booster doses must be completed within 2 weeks. Sri Lanka had begun inoculating booster shots to health workers and those above 60 years of age last month. With Christmas just around the corner, markets in India's southern Kerala state are flooded with a wide array of decorative items. Although Kerala has witnessed the highest spike in COVID-19 cases in India in the past months, shopkeepers say they are getting a good sale this season. Marking the annual commemoration of the birth of Jesus Christ, Christmas is celebrated across the world on December 25.
Markets in Kottayam in India's southern state of Kerala are flooded with a wide array of decorative items as Christmas is around the corner. Shops in Kottayam city are luring people with a variety of items including Christmas nativity sets, LED stars, Christmas trees, bells, lanterns and miniatures of Santa Claus. Marking the annual commemoration of the birth of Jesus Christ, Christmas is celebrated across the world on December 25th. Although the state has witnessed the highest spike in COVID-19 cases in India in the past months, shop sellers say they are getting a good sale this season.
അടുത്തതിന് കഴിഞ്ഞ കൊല്ലം കച്ചവടം കുറവായിരുന്നു. കഴിഞ്ഞ രണ്ടു കൊല്ലോട്ട് കച്ചവടമൊക്കെ കുറവായിരുന്നു. ഈ കൊല്ലം കച്ചവടം കയറി വരുന്നുണ്ട്. പ്രതീക്ഷയിലാണ് നല്ല കച്ചവടം ഉണ്ടാവുമെന്ന്. രണ്ടു കൊല്ലം കോവിഡായിട്ടൊക്കെ പ്രശ്നം വരുന്നല്ലോ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ കച്ചവടം കയറുമെന്നുള്ള ഒരു പ്രതീക്ഷയിലാണ്. പിന്നെ നമുക്ക് ഒരുപാട് സ്റ്റാർ ഐറ്റംസ് ഉണ്ട്. പിന്നെ പല പല മോഡൽസ് ഉണ്ട്. പിന്നെ LED ഐറ്റംസ്, LED സ്റ്റാർസ്, ഡെക്കറേഷൻ ഐറ്റംസ്, ട്രീകൾ, എല്ലാ സാധനങ്ങളും ഉണ്ട്.
Considered a season of love and peace, Christmas is widely celebrated in metros and other big cities across India by singing carols, lighting candles, decorating Christmas trees and exchanging gifts.
The high-tech spice park in Pampore district of India's northern Jammu in Kashmir to increase the quality and quantity of saffron production and solve the grievances of the growers is bringing cheers to the farmers of the region. Earlier, saffron growers were facing issues in drying, testing, packaging and proper marketing of their produce. But now, all these facilities are being provided under one roof.
To boost the cultivation and export of saffron in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir, the government has established a high-tech spice park in Pampore, also known as the Saffron Town. The high-tech spice park is bringing cheers to saffron growers who are getting a number of benefits as it plays a crucial role in improving the quality of Kashmiri saffron. It has solved the problems of saffron growers of the valley in maintaining the quality of their saffron. From drying, testing, packaging and proper marketing of the produce, saffron growers can avail the facilities under one roof.
एक फार्मर का प्रोड्यूस जहाँ पर जो उसका ओरिजिनल कश्मीरी सैफरन है वो लेने वाले तक पहुँचता है एक अच्छी तरीके से और एक गारंटेड चीज़ यहाँ पर अब होती है कि एक GI टैग भी मिला है और फार्मर को भी फ़ायदा काफ़ी हुआ है क्योंकि बाज़ार की रेट बहुत कम है और यहाँ की रेट बिल्कुल जो यहाँ पर एक्शन होता है उसकी रेट बिल्कुल सैफरन ग्रोवर को आता है बहुत अच्छी रेट आती है.
Saffron growers said that they are getting a lot of benefits in maintaining the quality of the saffron.
यहाँ पर हम फूल लाते हैं और हम यहाँ पर ही फूल यहाँ पर इतनी फैसिलिटी रखी है गवर्नमेंट ने कि हम यहाँ पर ही फूल ला के फिर यहाँ पर ही निकालते हैं जो आप देख रहे हैं अभी जो हम यहाँ पर काम कर रहे हैं फिर उसके बाद यहाँ पर ही जो हम सुखाते हैं यहाँ पर प्रॉपर तरीके से मशीनरी में ये सुखाते हैं और उसके बाद यहाँ पर ये पैक करके रखते हैं.
Saffron is one of the world's most expensive spices and Pampore is famed for its saffron production. Iran is the leading producer of saffron globally, followed by India.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.